Hello everyone, good morning. So here we continue the first chapter, measurement. Okay, so in last class we studied about units. Okay, so generally units can be classified into two types, which are local and standard units. Okay, so what is local unit? The unit which are used by few people in small area are called local units. For example, manapathi. Okay, so this manapathi system is a system of measurement of rice, okay, paddy, which is only being used in some parts of Nepal. So it is not used in other parts of the world, therefore it is a local unit used in a local area. Okay, similarly the second one is standard unit. Standard means it is used throughout the world by majority of the people. Okay, so we can define it like this: the unit which are used by large number of people throughout the world are called standard units. Examples are kilogram, meter, etc. Okay, so if you buy rice in Nepal, it is in kg. Okay, similarly the same thing applies for America or else part of the world, so therefore it is a standard unit. Okay, so there is one question that can be asked from this topic, reasoning question: why manapathi is called local unit and kilogram is called a standard unit? It can be answered like this: it is because manapathi is used by few people in a small area, but kilogram is used by large number of people throughout the world. Okay, so here is a question, this is for you: differentiate between local unit and standard unit. Okay, so first of all you can write definition, and second number you can write their example. Two difference will be enough. Our next topic is system of measurement. So I don't think this is a new topic for you, you have already studied in lower classes. Okay, so first one is CGS system, the system of measurement in which length is measured in centimeter, mass is measured in gram, and time is measured in second is called CGS system of measurement. Okay, second one is MKS system, the system of measurement in which length is measured in meter, mass is measured in kilogram, and time is measured in second is called MKS system of measurement. Similarly, third one is FPS system, the system of measurement in which length is measured in foot, mass is measured in pounds, and time is measured in second is called FPS system of measurement. 1 meter is equal to 3 foot and 3 inch. Okay, and similarly 1 kg equal to 2.2 pounds. So it is very easy to by heart this. From the name itself it is clear. Okay, CGS, C for centimeter, G for gram, and S for second. Similarly in MKS, M for meter, K for kilogram, and S for second. And in FPS, F for foot, P for pound, and S for second. So in this way you can remember the definitions. Okay, our next topic is SI system of measurement. So the main reason for developing SI system of measurement is there were already three systems. Okay, and in some parts of the world we used one system, and in another we used other system. So it was difficult in comparing the measurement. Okay, so this new system of measurement, which is known as SI system of measurement, was developed. Okay, it was developed by International Conference of Weight and Measurement in 1960 AD. The full form of SI system is Standard International System, or System International D Units also. Okay, and it is the extended form of MKS system. So some question which can be asked from this portion are as follow. The first one is, why was SI system developed? This answer will be, the SI system was developed to bring the uniformity in the measurement system throughout the world. Okay, second one is, why is SI system called the extended form of MKS system? So it can be answered like this: it is because SI system contains other fundamental and derived units, including the units of MKS system, that is meter, kilogram, and second. So these three systems are there already, and others are also there. Okay, so this is the extended form of MKS system. Okay, the third question is, differentiate between MKS and SI system. So at first you can write that it is the metric system of measurement, and in SI system it is the extended form of MKS system. And MKS system, it has only three fundamental units, whereas SI system has seven fundamental units and other derived units also. Okay, question is, why Newton is called derived units? This is the most question that is asked in this chapter. Okay, So the others will discuss tomorrow. Here I have given one. So first of all, while doing this, we'll write, we know that F is equal to M times G. M means mass and G is acceleration due to gravity. Now again we'll write there SI unit. Okay, so the SI unit of mass is kilogram and SI unit of acceleration due to gravity is meter per second square. Okay, so finally, since Newton depends upon fundamental units kilogram, meter and second, therefore it is a derived quantity. Okay, like this you can write. So here are these topics which we are going to discuss in next class: defining 1 kilogram, defining 1 meter, defining 1 second, and most important, interconversion of unit. Okay, so this much for today. We'll see tomorrow. Thank you.